Suzanne and her daughter Sarah, and they will be coming to sing for the whole next set, but they're going to help us out with a couple. This is my friend Chris Brown, and I am Kate Fenner, so we're going to play a few for you first, if that's okay. That song is called The Yield. It's a little bit about regret. This song is called Linden Trees, and it's, I don't know if anyone else spent their early 30s sort of wandering around looking for enlightenment. Wanting to be enlightened, but not wanting to change at all. So that was sort of my mission. Anyway, this is called Linden Trees.
Left out by the gutter. learn how to play the crowd. It takes on a moral duty. Drunk and fast and loud, take anything you want from me, but not my sadness and not my secrecy.
Block out the noise, bring home the war. Nobody knows us. Protect the heart, this is an art from the there can still be mystery. boat on the shore, the boat on the horizon. If you won't receive the wave at your door, you will become an island. So many years, so much at stake, oh, surely make it. 'Cause I haven't changed. Well, maybe I have, and you just couldn't take it. If you slow down, you can find peace. You can find peace here. You seek peace, you can make peace.
So let's see, I'm doing a little tour of my life, not on purpose, but now I'm almost 50 years old, and what's that, I've got a long way to go?
You're gonna see it.
Oh, okay, thank you. But I found lately, I used to be very level-headed, but lately I've found more ghosts in my life. I think the older you get, as people shuffle off this mortal coil, it's hard to let them go. So the song's called Ghost Moon, about a friend who died but showed up as the super blue blood moon. Is that what I'm going to say? Super blue blood when the moon is really low and red. And anyway, you're staring in my window.
Not good enough to be gold. The morning moon still hanging on. One light at the window pane. Ghosts, both of us up before dawn. Still I can't seem to get a move. Sun comes up cold in the sky, full of crows. Quiet and ice, can't I go when you go? You're new in the orbit of your eclipse, even the umbra of your eclipse. Ghosts, endlessly shaking your you lay for
Beautiful.
Kate Finner.
Yes.
It's Kate's first time in the Netherlands.
This is an extremely beautiful country.
Thank you.
Good food.
We know.
Yeah.
Beautiful cities, beautiful towns, beautiful
incredibly
trees.
Incredibly attractive people.
Just like Americans say.
Everyone's so fit on their bicycles and
smart.
Touring 101. Remember where you are and compliment the hell out of the people.
No, it's true. I've had the good fortune of coming to the Netherlands with Suzanne a number of times. We make records together. Kate and I grew up together making records since we were 15 and 16 years old. It's nice to be doing this over here. And she's
I was the 15-year-old. He was the 16-year-old.
How come you're 50 now and 40? How would that work?
I don't know. I keep wondering that too.
Yeah. My godson, I have various godchildren, one of which is Kate's son, Lucino, my godson. My other godson has a little friend when he was six. One time, his mom was going out and said, "Who's going to look after us?" And said, "Oh, Chris is here." And he turned to her and said, "Is he old enough?" I turned to the mom and I was like, "They think I'm one of them," which I'm fine with. This song I wrote for my goddaughter, Marley, because she is my teacher. With you, everything is music, everything is magic, and I know how to use it. Just let me hear your laughter, the greatest thing since silence, before and ever after. Spirit that is timeless, and everything you're seeking, I hope that you don't find it, just the sense that it keeps changing. And I hope that you don't mind it, the feeling nothing's ending, is what you bring to me. And as far as I'm concerned, if you notice you are free, keeper of the flame, but don't take it from me. The light that's in your eyes, anyone can see. And with you, time does not exist. To live is all is life. Yes, you teach me this. Something that's eternal, of which we're all a part, becomes so very clear. When I'm near your heart, there's things I'd never sell, as long as I may live. But I've been holding on to something you make me want to give. Your questions are my answers, your smile heals all doubt. I'll show you what I've learned, but you know what it's all about. You're the keeper of the flame, but anyone can see the way you want to live is the way it ought to be. Treasure of my life is plain enough to me. Are you alive? Souls, some aren't even trying. This love that's been restricted, measured and forbidden, ransomed and promoted, that might have just been given. But I like your translation, something just extend. You're a state beyond commission, without precedent. You're the keeper of the flame, but don't take it from me. The wonder of your heart, everyone can see. Keeper of the flame, freedom is your name. My keeper of the flame.
This morning in Utrecht. Do you like it? Sounds good, doesn't it?
We're just going to do a couple, three more.
Yep.
And we're going to get those cuties from the Jarvie Clark family back. Song and dance?
No.
Would you like to? That's your pleasure.
Does Suzanne? You can steal them.
This song is so, as Chris mentioned, we've been making music together for a very long time. And we toured in Canada, which is quite a proposition. Canada is a very big country. We went back and forth and back and forth. And lots in the United States and this song is, it's a little, I think maybe it's the song for Chris. Because it's a little bit about that time. You kind of get in the van, you drive somewhere, you get out, you sing a bit, you get back in the van, you stop at a gas station, have a quick pee, get some snacks, drive some more, sing some more songs. And then every once in a while you take it a little too seriously and you think, shouldn't I be more famous? Shouldn't something bigger be happening? Wasn't I meant for more? And then you remember, oh no, I'm just a song and dance man.
Safe place to be. I
Thank you. So nice to be here. What a lovely, lovely place. This song is called Passenger. It's about, you know, Suzanne, you will see when she plays, always gives great explanations of all her songs. And I'm a reader, so I like to know what's going on, and I really appreciate it. So I'm trying to do it in the spirit of Suzanne, but I just am not as good at it.
No, you are.
This song is called Passenger. A friend of mine was very ill, and his brother was driving him to and from his treatment. And he told me, at one point, he said, sitting in the front seat while his brother drives him in the sunlight coming in the afternoon, he said he felt more peaceful at that moment than ever in his life. And this song is for him. You don't know. everybody can go replenish their beverage. Beverage of choice.
We've been playing songs from Kate's album. This is from my new record, but we don't have it, so you can have it.
You can have it now.
Yeah, you can have it right now.
Live.
But Kate sings this on my new album, but it's a song that I wrote. I wouldn't have written if Kate didn't exist. Because there's certain songs you write for yourself, and there's other things. Because, as we were saying, Kate and I have been playing music together most of our lives, so certain songs like this, I just, not to objectify you, but you're an instrument at that moment. That's not bad, right?
Honored to be one. Or
a muse. A muse.
lovely drinks in hand, alcoholic or non-alcoholic. H2O, tea, whatever you prefer. Okay? Me, myself, I'm a tea gal tonight. So we're so happy to be here. So happy to be in the Netherlands. And tonight we're thrilled to be in this beautiful environment, beautiful room, the castle. When we played at Vim, we played at the record store, we did an in-store today. And Vim said, you're playing at the castle tonight. I was like, really? Will it be nights there? What will happen after the show? Anyway, so I'm going to play some songs from my new record. I hope you enjoy them. Really for the first time in 2011 after my older son had a near fatal accident. That's Sarah's twin brother, actually. He fell down a spiral staircase and had a very serious head injury. There was a long recovery period. He survived. It was a miracle, actually. It was completely unexpected, and he had to relearn everything. And one day, not that long ago, long after my first wave of songwriting, I was sitting with my guitar and I was playing a beautiful old vintage Gibson guitar, which makes a very different sound than this. And I was playing this. And I just got kind of lost in this sort of arpeggio and the sound of that guitar. And then I just imagined that I was inside my son's brain, that I was inside the cells and the spaces between the cells where the chemicals flow like snow, and I was waiting for him there. And he didn't show up because he's living with a brain injury and it's all for life. But I wrote this song about that, and I'm telling you a little bit about it because when I first made this record, a couple of people who were important said, "I love the record, but I don't really understand some of the songs. I think you're going to have to explain them." So I decided that this is one of the songs that it might help to explain a little bit. So when you're listening to the lyrics, if you're wondering why I mention Ion Channel, that's why.
Oh,
Thank you. So I hope the explanation was worth something for you as listeners. And it's an honor to be up here singing that song with my daughter.
Yeah.
It's very special. Because we walked that road together, her and I. This is a song about dealing with bad mood, bad energy. It blows in, it blows out. And it pushes you around, and then it's gone. Like a storm wreaks havoc, and then the sun comes out. It's called Point Blank.
So I've been playing, you know, live songs from the record since I released it officially in January in North America, and then here in February in Europe. And I had a CD release party where we played the whole record, but since that time I have not played this song that's on it called Matryoshka. The original name for the song was 70, but that's a word that appears in the chorus, and so we decided to think about it. Producer got upset, so I think you should think about changing the name. I was like, good God, man. That's a creative challenge. So we ended up calling it Matryoshka, which I don't know if you know. Matryoshka are those Russian nesting dolls. This is a song about forgiveness. Percentage of time where you play in Toronto and it's hit and miss whether you're going to get an audience that's actually listening, right? Mm-hmm. Chatting at the bar, talking through your whole set, you're just like, okay, I guess that's just the way it is. Whereas here, it's amazing. So thank you so much for listening so carefully. All right, this is the first song on my new record. It's called Headless Rider. About my wonderful daughter Sarah here.
So, I complained.
So she did. She complained that there were no songs written about her.
I was like, that's a good thing. You don't cause
me
angst.
Be careful what you ask for.
I said, it's such a good thing that I'm not writing songs, but it means that I think you're happy, and I'm happy when I think about you. Anyways. And now here she is, all those years of music lessons and
everything she had.
Thank you so much. So, welcome to our stage patter. So Chris has a great new album out called Patchum, but he doesn't have any copies left. So again, you just have to get live here tonight. but you can get his album online, and you can listen to it on Spotify too. Ooh, I don't really like Spotify. Although we all have surrendered to its power. We've all been told by the forces that be. So our music is up on Spotify, although I dream about a vast union of all musicians saying no. We will not. Anyways, Chris, do you want to introduce this song?
Sure. I was just thinking about the vast union of musicians saying no. It's like the Lysistrata. You know, where the women withheld sex until there was no more war. It's like if we withheld music until there was no more steering source. But I don't think that's the way it works. I think what it is that is there's just a deepening right now that's happening, and we haven't kind of caught up to it organizationally or monetarily. But what happens now is music is liberated, and good people like yourselves support us and support live music, and that's what we have to do. We do it too, you know. So it's just changing. But yeah, this is a song called To the Lighthouse, which happens to be one of my favorite books by Virginia Woolf, but I didn't really write. I have another song that I wrote for Virginia Woolf, but this has nothing to do with Virginia Woolf, other than the title. It's a song about a musician. Not at this point, Your Honor.
Any further submissions, cancel.
Yes, I just have one more submission. It's musical. Can I give it now?
Yes, you may give your submission.
Okay, here it comes. This is my only evidence right here. Something seemed to take from the very start. Love began to make a home out of my heart. I could feel it in my breath, know it by my thought. Childhood learns like something forgotten. Trust is hard, there is no doubt about it. But what is life? What are we without it? Our trust bending now. Trust the turning tide. Trust the sound of waves beating inside. Oh, what peace might I be? But it all feels complete. Perfection and despair, doubt, retreat. They were as bright as any morning, like a lighthouse, begging me. Away.
surface. Another town, another shore. Another chance at wealth. Another mystery. The chance of vision of myself. I'm going back the way the music started. Before the singer and the song ever parted. I'm going back to where the music started. Before the singer and the song.
Stages. It's one of the things I have to say about getting to produce my friends and work. We all make music together, but when you work on someone's record like I work on Suzanne's record, you get way, way into their songs. And it's really nice that when I comes around to me making a record, I go, hey, Suze, you want to sing on this? And she says, yes. It's like, okay, cool. It's reciprocal.
We grew up part of an artist collective, and we've been doing a lot of mix and match touring, I guess you could call it that, in the last year or so, where we tour in different permutations and combinations of each other and support each other on our songs. It feels really good. It's a recipe for real happiness, I would say.
What's real happiness?
Some sort of horrible cliche that I had to use a special voice in order to say the words.
Because there was no live app to turn your face into a skunk or something when he said it.
Not while I said it.
Can I just say that that's coming next?
No.
A skunk app?
No, live apps. You don't need your phone. You can just go, watch. You heard it here in this room. It's going to happen.
How will that happen?
What?
Let's not we digress.
Yeah,
there is not unlimited time for the set.
A discussion for the car home.
I'm just throwing it out there.
Yes, we love our car rides home after the show. Beautiful Netherlands. Everything's just so well taken care of. It's so orderly. I haven't encountered a road that even has a crack in it. Like, I live in Toronto where, the winter just is like a giant hand comes out of the sky and just clubs the city every season. And so there's roads that are literally like third world roads in my city. And like, shocks on my car, completely destroyed hands. Okay, I digress again. This is a serious song, though. I need to tone it down. I'm not going to say much. This is just a country murder ballad. Sort of a sexual assault and murder ballad. I'm sorry.
Really? Taking a train?
It's called The Core. This song involves a picking pattern pretty much all the way through. Science fiction out there in the real world. It's a story. It's inspired by a story. And I'm not going to tell you what it is. Maybe, you know, 0.0001% of everybody who ever listens to me will know what it is. That's okay. Because you can put any interpretation on it you want. But it is a little science fiction story. It's like a short story, so you just have to kind of listen and...
I'm the one who finds
nothing you recall or understand at all beyond your pride, my bride. Please help me to the bed. I am fading. My
I'm worried too, and I've been up all night.
winner, Sarah Jarvie Clark. Thank you also to Yom and Yos.
Yes.
Did I get that right?
Yes.
Yom and Yos. For booking us into this beautiful, just absolutely beautiful venue. So I hope you've all enjoyed it. I've got one more song here. When I first started writing, this was basically the first song I wrote in my whole real sort of song cycle. It's the first song of my old record, Spiral Road. We do have some CDs for sale. In case some of you are feeling nostalgic for the distant past, I would like to buy a physical object that actually has things like lyrics and artwork and paper you can touch. They're at the back there, and we'll be happy to chat with you after the show if you're interested.
No pressure.
No pressure. But we do like to sail on something but CDs. I wrote this song one day after coming home from the hospital. My son was there for a long time recovering, and about a month in, I came home and I picked up my guitar. And I was thinking about how much my life had changed since his accident. And I was just thinking about how it was just like that. I just got a phone call, and that was it. The accident happened, and then everything flowed from there. So I was sitting down just pondering, contemplating that in the flash of an eye, in the blink of an eye. It's just, you just never know. And how remarkably different it is, and there's no going back. So I wrote this upbeat song, but...
cheerful sounding.
It's good to juxtapose cheerful music with melancholy lyrics. They do it in bluegrass all the time.
It's called Before and After.